Silver Valkyrie, and welcome back to Skyrim. As you can see, we are in a new location. This is the museum safe house, and I did a whole tour on the safe house. Now, you're probably wondering, whoa, how did you get the safe house so quick? And I'll tell you. Basically, I recorded a whole two parts, and I explained this in the safe house tour video, but I should explain it again. I recorded two parts before this, but they were all crap. They were both crap. Nothing happened. We adopted Miko, and we donated some stuff to the museum that we found on the road. Literally, that was it. Nothing else happened. It would have been a 15-minute episode, and it wasn't good. So I scrapped them. I'm sorry. But like I said, all we did was adopt Miko, adopt Lucia, and that was pretty much it. I will try not to cut anything else out from here on out, but those two episodes, I wasn't feeling them at all. I didn't feel like my energy was good enough. I didn't feel like just the video in general was good enough. And I want each video that I upload to be at least somewhat entertaining, you know what I mean? So we are back with Lily. She now has two new family members. We have Miko and Lucia, obviously.
Mama.
Hi, Lucia. Hi, Mama. Now Lucia will actually wander around Solitude as well, I think, or the museum or something. But yeah, she's real cool. I love her. I'm actually gonna take Miko to a different spot. I might let him hang out in my room. Do you wanna come over this way, Miko? Come on. There you are. Let's talk about home. This place is your new home. Good boy. And then let's send him home. It's okay, Miko. There you go. And now he'll stay here. So Lucia won't make the stupid dog comments, because I hate those comments. They suck. They're not very nice. So today I wanted to, sorry if that was like a big cut just there. I wanted to finally get this bloody Jarl Balgruuf's greatsword out of my inventory. So I went and bought some ingots from the blacksmith in Solitude, and we're gonna make a replica of it. So here we go, we can make a replica greatsword. There we go. I'm gonna put the rest of my crafting materials in here, because I do not want to carry them around. I keep the mammoth tusk because that's for somebody. Tanker can go. Okay, there we go. Right, so now we only have the replica greatsword, and we have the real greatsword. So let's go and put the replica greatsword into. Hi, Lucia, are you stuck? We're gonna go put the replica greatsword on the in the museum. I don't know where it gets displayed, actually.
Yes, my friend.
Oh, sorry, Inigo. I was pushing E instead of W. I do that a lot. Okay. So let's go and display it. I don't know where it gets displayed. I couldn't tell you. I want to say in here, maybe? Shard Slayer. No. Okay. I have no idea. So let's just go and display it then. Which way is which? Not this way. I'm getting all turned around. Really testing out the everything. So here we are. In we go. Let's see. Okay, so all of this can't be done. That's fine. Here we are. Here is the replica greatsword for Jarl Balgruuf. In it goes. And now we can finally give this one back. Yes, please. I would like to know where it gets displayed. I genuinely have no idea. I'm going to assume it's in the armory somewhere. So maybe we'll have a look in the armory. I don't want to spend too much time here. I do want to go to Whiterun. And then we're going to fast travel to Whiterun. And then we're just going to kind of branch out from there, I think. There we go, new display. Let's have a look in the armory and see if it's in there. Yeah, we're just going to use Whiterun as like our sort of nexus. And just sort of pan out from there. Because I don't know, like, what... I don't know, like, what I want to do. With regards to that. I'm curious as to where the Whiterun sword went. Is it over there? We'll start off in Whiterun as like sort of a center for us, and then we'll just move up. As and when, you know, you have to. So we'll start in Whiterun, and then we will, I don't know, maybe head to... Let's have a look and see what we got, shall we? So maybe we will pop to Windhelm quickly, tell Aventus that Grelod's dead, and then after that, we will head to Whiterun, give the Jarl his sword, and then maybe we'll go and have a little chat to Cicero. Sounds like a good plan, I think. Okay. So.
Interesting.
That is that. I'm still really curious as to where the sword went. Tell you what, I have a little look around. I have a little little run around, see if I can find it. If I can't, then I'll meet you in Windhelm. All right, so I couldn't find the sword, but I did find this button in Dragonborn Hall, and this will uncover this little hatch here. So this goes into the Hall of Secrets, and it's kind of an interesting place because it's kind of just like in like a little sewer by the looks of it. Like this isn't what should be inside a museum, right? But it just leads into here, and it started a quest called Arya Morellis in the Chamber of Secrets. So. Yeah, there's like a hidden room, and this room will be used for Dark Brotherhood stuff, Thieves Guild stuff, and the vampire line if we do that. So let's find Arian and see where he is. Dragonborn Hall, okay. So, instead of walking all the way back, we can just fast travel there. That probably would have been quicker just to walk. Here he is. So, hey, Arian. Oops.
Hmm?
What's the story with the hidden room under the Dragonborn Hall?
Oh, the Hall of Secrets. I had all but forgotten about it, to be honest. When we broke ground on the foundation of the museum expansion, we accidentally broke through into a sealed-off chamber that was built under the Pelagius wing of the Blue Palace. When I asked them about it, it apparently used to be some sort of panic room for Pelagius when he was in one of his more violent manic episodes. They sealed it off long before the rest of the wing and forgot all about it. I asked for permission to use the room as a bit of a secret storage vault in case Solitude was ever invaded. I would store the relics there and lock down the museum. They gave permission, and I had the tunnel finished and access in the hall made.
Could I use it as a private display space away from prying eyes?
Certainly. I suppose if you are ever in need of a place to store items of a more questionable nature,
questionable,
that would be ideal. I'll go ahead and outfit it for you, but I'll take a nobody asks, nobody tells approach to it, and you do with the room as you like. And I won't plan on taking any tours down there either. I should have it all cleaned up for you by tomorrow.
Excellent, thank you.
See you around.
Okay, so, also, another thing you missed in the last two parts was he just gave us a thing. A little quest to go and search Chilfar Farm for a artifact. So we will do that as well while we're in Whiterun. But first of all, like I said, I would like to head to Windhelm first to let Aventus know that we've killed Grelod. We killed Grelod a while ago, actually. So, like I said, I don't want to fast travel too much. And as soon as we get to Whiterun, I think the fast traveling will, like, sort of slow down a lot. Because I would like to just go through it and just search any caves that we find and, you know, that kind of stuff. So, let's see. Do we have a fur hood by any chance? No.
My job? Well, I'm the watcher of the wheel, which is... Watching the wheel isn't as simple as you might think.
The wheel?
Have to inspect all the way around the ice. Make sure it's not melting.
Okay. So let's head up to Aventus and tell him that Grelod is indeed dead.
Well, Grelod the Kind. Is she, you know...
Grelod is dead.
I knew you could do it. I just knew it. I knew the Dark Brotherhood would save me. Here, just like I promised, this should fetch you a nice price. Thank you. Thank you again.
You're welcome. So, I'm curious. Does the Arantino family heirloom have a spot in the museum? It does. Okay, cool. It's good to know. Alright, so let's head to Whiterun. Do I still have my water skins on me? Or am I gonna have to go back to the safe house and get them? Because, no, yeah, I do. Okay, that's good. I don't have any food on me though. So, I'm literally gonna have to. I turned off the needs while I was fast traveling back and forth. Just to do some testing. And I haven't forgot to turn them back on. So let's turn them back on. There we are. Let's head to Whiterun and we will start from there. We'll go and give the Jarl his sword. We can probably finish doing that. So I think first of all, we'll head to the stables. We'll take a ride to Chilfar Farm. We'll go and see Cicero and then we'll head back, I think. That sounds like a good idea. So when we get here, we're going to be hungry. Oh no, so we will have to go in. See, we're hungry and thirsty, so we will indeed have to go in. So let's take Frost on a little ride up to the gate.
Do
Come
you
on,
know
Ego.
How to ride that animal?
Of course I do. Let's take Frost on a... Oh, no, it's the courier. Do you want me to get down? Oh, my God, did you just see...
I've been looking for you.
Hello.
Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. Yeah, got this note.
From who?
Don't know. Creepy fella. Black robe. Couldn't see his face. Paid me a pretty sum to get that into your hands, though. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
What note is this? A mysterious note. Ah, here we go. We have set in motion a chain of events now. We have set in motion the Dark Brotherhood questline. I guess that's kind of a spoiler, but I feel like if you haven't played Skyrim by now, why? I'm sure there are reasons why people might not have played Skyrim at this point. But, you know, I feel like everybody's played Skyrim at this point. So the Dark Brotherhood isn't really a spoiler, I guess. But if it is, I'm sorry. Alright, here we are. Lovely white run. Okay, so, first of all, we need some food and we need some drink. We are getting colder. Hi, Uthgard. How you doing, friend? Yes, so.
A few septims for my supper is all I ask.
I'll give you some septims. Here you go.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Divine
bless your kind heart.
Right. Well, let's go get some food from Hulda.
We got warm food, warm drinks, and warm beds.
Hulda. Oh, I can just take this, can I? Why can't I just take it?
If it's work you need, how about chopping up some wood for the fires?
No. What have we got for sale?
Take a look.
So I need some food, Hulda. Preferably some ready-made food. Because I accidentally sorted all mine in my house and I cannot be asked to go and find it. So let's just buy some soup, some cooked beef, chicken, some grilled leeks. We don't want to spend too much money. Let's get some sweet rolls for dessert, a venison stew, treat ourselves, why not? Vegetable soup, tomato soup. There we go, I think we have enough. But also, can I get a refill,
of
please?
Of course.
Thank you very much. Thank
Need
you.
Anything else? Just let me know.
Let's eat this some of this lovely food that we just bought. How's that? Just eated some soup. Oh, we're in the green anyway, so we're fine. I'm also wondering if there is anything around that can go to the museum, like any amulets or anything, maybe. Let's see, are any like special things that are museum worthy? It doesn't look like it. What's that? Ooh, some cheese. Hell yeah. All right. Thank you, Hulda. I will be leaving now. You don't have anything else that I have need of. So, while we're here, we might as well go and deliver Balgruuf his sword.
Fresh from the wilds.
I don't know what he gives
Someone's
me for it.
Pilfering crops from my
I know
farm.
Your family's honor is important to you, but we can't afford it.
It took me weeks to find that thief's den. I can't stop now. And I can't get the sword on my own.
Trouble?
You tried mercenary work?
What were you arguing about?
My Saphir doesn't like that I've been spending so much time looking for my father's old sword. He fed his entire family with the gold he made using that weapon. I'm not about to let it gather dust in some thief's trophy room.
Do you need help finding it?
I tracked it to a group of bandits nearby. But I'm no fool. I'd need the Whiterun guards or maybe hire the companions to get it. I don't know why I'm saying this, but if you find it out in your travels, I'd be grateful to you.
Sure, I'll have a look.
Sword,
to starve your wife and daughter to reclaim some rusty old
sword. Hi, Ayla.
If you Isgrimor himself wouldn't have the patience to deal with all the rabble around here.
Okay. Ooh. Let's go and activate the Shrine of Talos. I do not want to accept Talos though. Yeah, there we go. We have the Blessing of Talos, which means that, yeah, there we go. The Shrine of Talos should be added to the museum, which is awesome. But let's head into Dragon's Reach and give old Proventus the Jarl's Greatsword. And so we can get it out of our inventory. Finally! There's also a free cape here if you want a Whiterun cape. Now, I am sure there is multiple good stuff here.
Now, where is it?
It takes a while to make a dress, Dagny. You have to be patient.
But I don't want to be patient. I want my dress right now.
I serve Jarl Balgruuf as steward.
One of the new servants?
Another one.
Remember that, like, I'm going
Father
to
says
Baldi
I'm too young.
Oh, please shut up. Hi, Proventus.
The Jarl is, as you can imagine, very busy. Perhaps I can assist you.
I have a sword.
Your visit to the task of steward is more important.
I have a sword for you.
From Adrian?
Yes.
Ah, this must be that weapon for the Jarl. Poor girl. So eager to prove herself. I'll present it to Balgruuf when his mood is agreeable. Thank you. Please, take these few coins for services rendered.
Thank you for the 20 coins.
If
very
any
kind
I can help
of
you.
You
with, just let me know.
Let's have a little look see around, shall we? I'm pretty sure there is an there's an artifact in the Jarl's quarters that we need to grab. But I'm not gonna do that yet because the Jarl doesn't like us yet. As soon as we've killed the dragon, then we will be able to go and pilfer everything that the Jarl owns. But while we're here, actually, there's a whole bunch of stuff here. I can just take that. Farangar, if you could just, like, walk away. Oh, really? You're gonna sit there? That's where you're gonna... Oh, really? That's what you're gonna do? Oh, for God's sake. I don't want to pickpocket him. I just want the cards. There we go. That one. You can steal the Dragon Forge. Oh, look, we can pickpocket. That's going to be hard. Wow, that's very expensive. Oh, he has a one-handed attack ring. Thanks, Farangar. There we go. Let's have a little look-see in here, see if he has anything. All those books we will need as well. Or some of them, anyway. Anything else here? Nope, doesn't look like it. Okay. I shall be leaving. Alright, let's head down to the... Let's head back to Frost. And then we can just chill out. Have a nice ride over to... Chillfarrow Farm. And, And maybe grab Cicero along the way. Actually, before we do that, there is a Temple of Kinareth here, or Kinareth, that we can head in and activate the shrine to. Oh wow, healing magic going on. That's cool. I like that. So yeah, here is a shrine that we can do. Which will get activated in the museum. Let's have another little look-see around before we talk to Danica.
Welcome, child.
Wow. Look at that cheese.
How do you feel?
I can't eat nothing. I know I'm stealing from, like, nice people, but I'm sorry.
Patience. The body needs time to mend.
Where is Danica? Are you here? Danica, are you here? Okay, I guess Danica is not here. I wanted to get the tree quest so that while we're up by Helgen, we can go and do that quest as well. Hi, Danica.
It's a shame, isn't it?
Tell me about this tree.
This is the Gildergreen. It was planted as a seedling in the early years of Whiterun. Disciples of Kinareth could sense something holy in it and traveled far to hear the winds of the goddess in its branches. They built the temple. Of course, not as many pilgrims these days.
What's so special about the tree?
To the east of here is a hidden grove where the Eldergleam resides. It's the oldest living thing in Skyrim, maybe all of Tamriel. Our tree here in the city was grown from a cutting of that tree. You can still feel the glory of the mother tree through it. Even its name is an echo.
Is there any way to revive the tree?
I've thought about that. Trees like this never really die. They only slumber. I think if we had some of the sap from the parent tree, we could wake up its child. But even if you could get to the Eldergleam, you couldn't tap it. Not with any normal metal.
What kind of weapon would work?
Elder Gleam is older than metal, from a time before men or elves. To even affect it, you have to tap into the old magic. You'll have to deal with the Hagravens. I've heard about the weapon they've made for sacrificing Spriggans. It's called Nettlebane. The hags terrify me, or I would have gone after it myself.
I'll get it for you.
Your spirit is strong. Kinnereth's winds will guide your path. It's held in a Hagraven nest called Orphan Rock.
All right. Orphan Rock, Nego. That is where we have to go. We're not going just yet, though. We will definitely do the Nettlebane thing. But not just yet. That pot made me bleed. Oh, not you again. Oh, he's walking away. Phew. Nothing for me?
Nope. Sorry. Nothing.
Good. Right. Hello, Frost. Come on, Ego. Grab our attacks. Let's head out. We are heading to Chilfer Farm. And also, we are going to assist a jester on the road. Wherever he may be. And we will discover all of this along the way also, I think. Well, at least everything on this side of the river, because I don't want to ride through the river with Frost. Alright, so this is the Honeybrew Meadery, I believe. Yep. Oh, yeah, Honeybrew Meadery. Head down this way. Nern route alert. There's an Imperial and some sort of lady. Oh wait, hang on. We've just completely gone past Chilfer Farm. Okay, here is Chilfer Farm. I don't know if it's a crime to be inside. It very well could be. So, yeah, what's the time? Yeah, it's only 7 p.m. So tell you what, why don't we make a camp set up? Should we set up a camp? Just like here. We could set up a camp. What do you reckon, Inigo? Hopefully we have enough wood. No, we don't have enough wood. We don't have any wood. So, we're gonna have to go near some trees. Oh my god, what is happening? Who are you? Is he... Hello? Are you mean?
You've already lost. Like the fight of a flea. I'll fix you good.
You seem nasty.
Enough of this.
Oh god, John Battleborn's having a go. Oh my god. You what? Well, this is new. I already have pickaxe, but sure. Camilla's note. Isidore, got a delving job for us. Meet me out near Cragwallow Slope in Eastmarch. Leave as soon as you get this. I hear tell of some ruins there leading into the Velothi Mountains, just uncovered by a landslide, they say. This is big, fresh ruins. If we could be the first to pick them over, we could be rich. Who knows what's down there, though? Bring the best gear you can lay hands to. Pick off someone on the road with good stuff if you have to. Just get it and get it to me as quick as you can, Camilla. Well, Camilla seems nice. Anyway, back to what we were doing. Let's go into the trees and chop some dead wood.
Excuse me, my friend.
Hello.
Something
what's up?
On your mind?
No, I thought there was something on
okay,
your mind.
Let us get back to it.
Yeah, let's head back up to Frost and we can build a little campsite. And then in the morning we'll go and help the jester and go into the farm when it's not a crime. But then is it ever not a crime? Do you think it's illegal to camp here? Nah, it's not illegal. Why would it be illegal to camp here? Build campfire. Here we are. Right. Let's place a campfire here. We will use it. Let's do light fire and magic. Yay, campfire. Excellent. Good, good. Right, now let's pitch our tent, Inigo. Right. Here is our tent. Place. Just let it get set up first, Inigo. Here we are. Look at this. Wow, isn't this nice? Isn't this nice? What do you reckon? What do you reckon? Good, huh? Do you like it, Inigo? Yeah, let's see, we're warming our hands now. You gonna come and join? Yeah, you're joining in. This is it. Oh my god, Artax is here. I guess Artax wanted to join in. Alright, let's eat some stuff while we're here. We might as well. Some cabbage stew and have a bit of a drink. And yeah, let's go to sleep for a little bit. Let's sleep for not quite 12 hours, maybe 10 hours? Oh no! Hello?
Sleep well?
Where am I? Who are you?
Does it matter? You're warm, dry, and still very much alive.
I was warm and dry in my tent.
That's more than can be said for old Grelod,
You know about that?
Half of Skyrim knows. Old hag gets butchered in her own orphanage. Things like that tend to get around. Oh, but don't misunderstand. I'm not criticizing. It was a good kill. Old Crone had it coming. And you saved a group of urchins to boot. But there is a slight problem.
A problem?
You see, that little Aretino boy was looking for the Dark Brotherhood. For me and my associates. Grelod the Kind was, by all rights, a Dark Brotherhood contract. A kill that you stole. A kill you must repay.
You want me to murder someone else? Who?
Well now, funny you should ask. If you turn around, you'll notice my guests. I've collected them from... Well, that's not really important. The here and now, that's what matters. You see, there's a contract out on one of them, and that person can't leave this room alive. But, oh, which one? Go on. See if you can figure it out. Make your choice. Make your kill. I just want to observe. And admire. Am I to take your silence as acceptance? Then you know where we stand. Make your kill and we're square. Repayment of your debt is but a discreet knife thrust away.
Okay. So, yeah. I wasn't expecting to be doing this in this episode, but here we are. Well, let's talk to them, shall we?
Is this about that raid last week? I told Holgrim there was no honor in killing sleeping men, but he wouldn't listen. It wasn't my fault, I swear.
Would someone pay to have you killed?
What? Oh, God. I don't want to die.
Don't be afraid, you can tell me.
Okay, well,
hey.
I guess it's possible. I've been selling my sword arm for years now. Killed a lot of people. Could be someone wanted revenge. But you're not going to kill me, right? What did I do?
Get these things off of me.
Whatever it is. I'm sorry.
Would someone pay to have you killed?
Excuse me. What kind of question is that?
It's all right. Tell me what I need to know.
I'm a woman living in Skyrim with six children and no husband. I don't have the time or the patience to be nice. Do some people look down on me? Have I made some enemies? You're damn right.
Who are you?
None of your damn business who I am. If you're going to kill me, just do it already.
Oh.
Whoever this is, clearly we got off on the wrong foot.
I've got a home to
no
keep
worries.
And children to feed.
This is not the first time I... Come now, whatever the problem, we can talk about it like civilized folk.
Would someone pay to have you killed, Vasha?
Me? Are you serious?
Come on, you can tell me. We're all friends here.
The real question is, would someone pay to have me killed again? A day goes by without someone trying to cut me in the street. I get disappointed. Tell you what. You release me, and I promise my associates will not hunt you down like an animal and butcher you in the street.
I'm sorry, but I can't have associates tracking me down and murdering me in the streets. You do have some nice clothes, though. I'll take them. And your hood. Let's see what you look like, shall we? Just a regular Khajiit. Okay, well...
What's happening? Cowards. Stealing a woman from her home.
Hey, the only reason I left you alive is because you have six children, lady.
When I get out of here, you're dead. Do you hear me? Dead!
Don't tempt me, woman. Do not tempt me.
The conniving Khajiit. Cat-like.
She's still going on.
Sure to have enemies. It's no wonder you chose him.
So who was it? Who had the contract?
Oh, no, no, no. Don't you understand? Guilt, innocence, right, wrong, irrelevant. What matters is I ordered you to kill someone, and you obeyed.
So I'm free to go?
Of course. And you've repaid your debt in full. Here's the key to the shack. But why stop here? I say we take our relationship to the next level.
I agree, Astrid.
I would like to officially extend to you an invitation to join my family, the Dark Brotherhood. In the southwest reaches of Skyrim, in the Pine Forest, you'll find the entrance to our sanctuary. It's just beneath the road, hidden from view. When questioned by the Black Door, answer with the correct passphrase, "Silence, my brother." Then you're in, and your new life begins. I'll see you at home.
Okay. Astrid, lovely Astrid.
Remember, the sanctuary is in the southern pine forest.
Lovely Astrid.
Just beneath the road and away from prying eyes.
I was so salty when I did this thing, when I did this quest the first time, when I realized that you couldn't,
release me!
I thought you could actually release them.
I don't have time for this nonsense. I've got a home to keep and children to feed. Now,
look,
let me
even if I could release
here.
You, I wouldn't. Bye, Astrid. See you later. Oh, great. Where the hell are we? Inigo! Thanks for showing up, I guess. Do I still have my tent? No, it's still in the middle of Whiterun. God damn it. Where are we? Well, if we're gonna RP, let's RP instead of heading straight back to Whiterun. Let's have a little look around Morthal, I guess. In fact, I would like to find the Eldergleam Sanctuary, perhaps. I know it's around here. But, we may freeze to death. I won't lie to you. But it's okay. We have spells. We can harvest wood and make a fire, and Inigo, so don't worry. There we are, look, see, Inigo, you found extra wood, that's good, good job. Yes, do not worry. Oh, we're gonna have to go through, like, water. Oh. I hope you like swimming. Oh, goodness. Oh my god, it's freezing! We should not have done that. What is that? Oh my god, it's Inigo, it's spiders. Oh my god. Eek. Why am I freezing though? I thought I'd be okay. I have like a good cloak on. Morthal's just over there. Is this the Eldergleam Sanctuary? Because I'm... Oh, luckily this isn't water. Because is this Eldergleam Sanctuary? I hope it is. Oh, no, this is worse. This is Morvarth's lair. We do not want to be going into Morvarth's lair, Inigo. Morthal is just up here. Yeah, there it is. So maybe we'll just head to Morthal instead. We will find the Eldergleam Sanctuary before we actually do the quest. Because I would like to take it a different way. We need to hurry because we are freezing to death. Here we go, Morthal, good. There is a... Yeah, we're walking very slowly now because we are very cold. Oof. Where is the inn? Yeah, okay. A courier, again!
I've been looking for you. Got something
for
I'm supposed
God's
to deliver.
For God's sake!
Your hands only. Let's see here. Ah, there's a new lady in charge of the orphanage.
Oh, you
Looks
did
like
that
that's
because...
It.
Because of an orphanage? I need to get to the inn or somewhere. We've got to be almost there. I don't know what's going on over there, but here it is, right? This is the inn. Moorside Inn.
Finally, someone comes in. Kick off your boots, stay a while. Let me know if there's anything I can help you with. I got nothing but time these days.
Oof. We are very cold. Are you warm yet? Oof.
Well, aren't you the
Hello.
Pretty one? I bet all the men chase after you.
Some do. I mean, not really. I am a dark elf, and dark elves, people don't like dark elves in Skyrim, apparently. Or Windhelm, I suppose. Tired, Nico? Well, we have to warm up a bit first. And then we can go and chat to them outside. Is there anything cool in here I can maybe steal? Oh. I'll take some money. Sorry, I don't like stealing from people, but you know, desperate times and all. Oh, there we are. We are completely on the Windhelm letters. Okay, we'll steal it. And I'm just gonna take these. Ooh, more side cheese wheel. Yep, I'll take it. I assume that's the person who owns the place. Oh, Lurbuck, I know you. Okay, well, now we're completely warm. I think we need some sort of hood, right? I can't wear an execution hood. Jesus. But we need some kind of hood, I think. You look warm there, Inigo, and you're covered in fur, so, you know. Let's go and see what's wrong with these guys.
What's the Jarl going to do about it? How are we supposed to feel safe in our own homes?
Please, enough already. I have told Ygritte of
sorry.
Your concerns.
Nothing.
Look after you all. Please, go about your business.
We have no need for wizards in our midst.
Morthal has enough problems as it is.
Hi.
It's no use. Let's get back to it then.
Nope. Sorry.
Hello?
Keep your wits about you. Morthal's hardly a safe place.
Unless it's
Hello?
About the meal. I don't have time to talk. Too much to do.
What isn't the Jarl dealing with?
Trust you saw the house that burned down. Peculiar bit of business that was. And that's on top of noises from the marsh in the night. Tales of monsters. And now this wizard in our midst. What's a man to do if he can't look to his Jarl for help?
You seemed upset.
The world's going mad, and our Jarl does what? She hides inside with her visions. We need a leader, not some mystic.
Fair enough.
All right, then.
Nope. Sorry. Nothing.
No one asked. All right. Well, I think that is going to do it for this episode. Whoa. We had such a determined termination to go and do some stuff in Whiterun today. And then we were just waiting for Chilfar Farm, and it's like, oh, okay, I guess Astrid's just going to come and steal us, I suppose. Thanks, Astrid. And now we're in Morthal. So, but like I said, we're going to RP it. We're going to stick to it. We're going to make our way back to Whiterun. Shouldn't take too long. The map's not as massive as it looks. we can easily make our way back to Whiterun. Or maybe we will maybe just to, like, explore here a little bit. Like explore Morthal a little bit. Because I gotta say, I've never really spent too much time here, but we can explore the marshlands a bit and discover some caves. Maybe we can go in some caves. Maybe explore more of Solitude Hold. And then once we're ready to move on, we can come down here, hit up Rorikstead, and head back to Whiterun. And then over here to Falkreath. Because I believe there's a little somebody waiting for us in Falkreath. And there's also somebody waiting for us over here, too. But actually, this would be a nice place to go, because this is like the heat geysers, isn't it? This is where like all like the geysers are, and it's nice and warm. So here might be a good place to go and see. What is that? Velothi Mountain Tunnels? What? I don't know what that is. Revakheim? I don't know what that is. Oh my god. There's so much to do, so much to see. I'm very excited. I hope you guys are too. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked it, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. I upload 3 days a week and I stream 4 days a week over on Twitch. All of my links are in the description box, and if I don't see you before, I will see you guys next time. Goodbye!